Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, our Lord, announcing the gospel in the whole world was never an easy job. In the first place, the number of the disciples was quite low in Jesus' time. But that is again the case nowadays. And the duty to pronounce the gospel through concerning all Christians is a special duty, of course, of the bishops, the priests, and the deacons, and the numbers of in particularly the priest is low at the moment, especially in the Western world. And they have a special role in bringing peace between God and us, and consequently between us human beings, by announcing the Christian faith, the gospel, by celebrating for us the sacraments, especially the precious sacrament of the precious body and blood of Christ. Jesus therefore urges us constantly to pray for vocations, for laborers, for the harvest. Dear brothers and sisters, apart from the fact that I have to fulfill this duty with low numbers, Jesus foretells them that not everybody in this world is exactly waiting that message of peace. Behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. And besides, Jesus incites his followers not to rely in confronting this difficulty on mainly on human means, money, and other equipment. In saying that they should not greet no one along the road does not mean that Jesus incites his disciples to be impolite. He means to say, don't rely mainly on your human relationships, however influential they may be. For instance, on politicians, and the church made these mistakes, as you know, very often, too often. No, they should announce the gospel in a way which bears testimony to the fact that they themselves put all their trust mainly in the kingdom of God, in his grace, the power he gives us. And brothers and sisters, today's gospel concerns us, the contemporary Christians, in a particular way. We can feel ourselves very tiny and weak compared to the nowadays dominant, seemingly mildly, very secularized and hyper-individualist culture. In this world, at times hostile, and at least little accessible to Christian faith. Dear brothers and sisters, would that not totally discourage you and me? Should we really try to go on, to continue to announce it when so many people, so few people accept it? Dear brothers and sisters, my answer will not be a surprise for you. Of course, I say yes. We should announce the Christian faith to the if the world is listening or not. Why? I have two good reasons. At least I myself find two good reasons. In the first place, Jesus said to us, do not think that you are so powerless and without means. Behold, I have given you the power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and upon the full force of the enemy, and nothing will harm you. In the southeast of the United States, in the hills of Appalachia, there are some Pentecostal communities which takes these words of Jesus literally. And therefore, they use snakes in the religious services. During the service, pastor and others following, other people present courageously dance around the pulpit with snakes in their hands. When they feel, they seem to feel the unction of the Holy Spirit. These people view the risk they run by taking poisonous snakes in their hands and to be bitten by them. They take this as a proof of their faith. Some even think that we once should produce this proof of faith in order to come into heaven. At least you have to admit that these services are not done. But before you start to think about doing so, I have to warn you, because things are not always going that well. Years ago, National Geographic broadcasted a documentary in which such a search service was shown. Several participants had lost fingers, part of their hands, even whole forearm, as a consequence of the snake bites. In 2013, it was reported that the pastor had died after being bitten by a snake. And first he said, oh, I don't need medical care. In the end, he went to the hospital, but then it was too late. Dear brothers and sisters, do we not have to conclude that the words of Jesus about grasping snakes are not true? Yes, they are most certainly true. However, we should realize to whom Jesus directs these words, to the 12 apostles and the 70 disciples he sent. That means he gave his power to the church as a whole, and not to you or me or some other individual. And what happened? The church went over the whole world and proclaimed and still proclaims the word of God. And doing so through the ages, she was bitten by all types of snakes, with inverted commas, from all sides. Many persecuted her, have tried to persecute her, to suppress her, to eliminate her. And this is still happening. But the church is still alive and will remain alive till the end of time. brothers and sisters, many great saints have shown their faith and trust in Jesus by the courage with which they proclaimed the gospel. The symbol of this was that by their faith some of them could cope with the confrontations with snakes. For instance, one of you, yes, I'm serious, one of you, the boss of the Netherlands, Saint Willibrord, of which I am the 17th proud successor. Saint Willibrord, this English monk, had the courage to leave his safe homeland in order to announce the gospel in the Low Countries. And that was a dangerous affair, because also at that time we were as stubborn and little accessible to Christian faith as we are now. And Saint Willibrord, during one of his mission journeys, met the daughter of a pagan female priest of the goddess of Rida, and she was bitten by a snake. And by praying for her, Saint Willibrord achieved to heal her. And by this, he got the opportunity to proclaim the gospel in her village. Dear brothers and sisters, I still promised you a second motive to announce the gospel, notwithstanding all challenges. The Holy Spirit is also at work in the present culture. The Church still convinces people to become Christians, however few that may be. That happens. And suppose now that we would only be able to convert only one single person to Christ, nobody else. The Jerusalem Talmud, an authoritative record of rabbinic discussions on Jewish law, says whoever saves a single life is considered by Scripture to have saved the whole world. It is worthwhile taking the efforts and defying all difficulties to announce the Christian faith also today. Why? For whoever brings only one human being to Christ, he saves somebody who, created in the image of God, has a value